I will now show you some tooling that FiberWorks offers to make entering a design more easy. You can see the tools here, and you can also find them under edit and the drawing mode. Well, it's just the easiest way to show it, to show what it does by doing it. So I put my mouse pointer here, and when I click my left mouse and I keep it clicked in, and I move my mouse to the left, now you can see what happens. So if I want to have this pattern only on the first four shapes, then I only go up four, but of course you can go up and use more shafts, and you see what happens here. You can also do it from left to right, and then the order changes. You see this? And well, you can also use the point draw. You see here how it behaves, and I keep my mouse, my left mouse button, I keep this all the time clicked in. And well, let's do line draw. You can see you can play with it, and you can see that the width varies. If you only have a small block, of course it can only have one block per time, but the moment it gets bigger, you can see that the blocks get wider. So it just calculates that. So you can do that. And then last but not least, we have freehand, and you can just play like this, what you as you please. You can also use these tools for your traveling draft. So if you use it like this, and of course now you see here the drawdown is filled in, but we didn't do the tie up yet, so it doesn't really make sense. Again, point to draw, and you can click anywhere that you please. And well, the line draw again. You can mix anything you want freehand, and you can also work from bottom to top. And you can also use this for your tie-up, if that pleases you. You see that now something weird happens here. Oh, no, of course it's not weird. That's how your weaving will look if you would use this one. And, well, I must say that if you just want to have fun, you can play with it and get very funny effects. And okay, if it's probably not weavable because these huge floats, but okay, it's fun to play with. And well, just give it a try. And well, if you have a very simple thing going on and want to use this simple pattern, and here you do it here, you know, you can play with it and look what effects it gives. So that's about the drawing tools. Another way that you can use to quickly fill in your designs is through the menu, and you can choose warp fill. So what I will show now, I will show that for the warp. But you can also use this for the tethering. It works the same. So let's choose warp fill. Well, you can see you have a couple of ways that you can do this. And well, you can here say how much repeats you want, and you can tell if the things you have entered here, if it has to be added to the end, or that you have just want to replace everything. And here you can tell about how many frets is used. So let's play around with it. Let's choose 2 and 3. You see here now that the number of frets is 24. Well, let's make it 26 and see what happens, and then use this, and you see that it is, you have 2 extra frets used here. Well, let's do that again, warp fill, and let's choose for reversed, and let's do that 4 times and on 35 fret, and let's add it to the end, and you see here that it goes here. Well, I will also show you how you can, this here is in select mode already, and I want to remove a couple of things, so I want to remove this, and I just hit the delete button because I want to show you something that is very clever, because suppose you do a straight draw again and you do one repeat and you say add to the end, you see that it doesn't start here with number 1, 2, 3. No, it is very nicely connected to this one. So that's very nice. And of course it doesn't happen when you have ended here with a kind of odd bit. Okay, let's choose point draw, and if it goes up and down again, you know that default it is 15 frets with 8 shafts. So let's use 3 repeats, and let's add it to the end, and you see that you have 3 points. Now, you can also use this thing, rose path, and let's make it 7 times, and this time we will use replace all, and you can see that change. So that was another way to quickly fill in your design.